pristine rose is high and dry. This is the only thing keeping us alive.
For the past 2 weeks, former Mr. Gold, Shawn Pomrenke, has been working hard at his inland mine, fighting his way to $400,000 to buy his fleet out of bankruptcy.
I've been running a week or so on the box. I'm working night and day. Time to do a cleanup.
And today, he'll find out if he's lifted enough remaining ounces to pull it off.
If we don't hit 140 ounces, we won't make it. I'll lose everything. I don't plan on that happening.
A bad business deal left the captain high and dry. His prize dredge, the Christine Rose, and the Mega Dredge project have been seized.
Sucks that I have to buy all the stuff I've already paid for back. The only thing I have is the inland mine. We'll see if it pays off. We're pulling the header carpet. This is where you catch a majority of your gold. There's a little pile of cheese. We'll see. No, I can't make any projections until the gold's on the scale. Looks like we're on point, though.
This is by far the biggest hole I've had to dig myself out of.
Time to clean some gold.
Fortunately, I'm really good at digging. It was looking really good. Maybe not as good as what I thought.
That's everything?
I thought it was gonna be more.
Me too.
That's it looked like more in the bucket. Disappointing.
Going into this cleanup, I need as much money as I can to get my stuff back. There's 26. That's 100. 20, 30. $145. $146,
big dog.
We got the boats back.
By the hair on my chinny chin chin, I came up with the $400,000. It's a great feeling. Start working my way back to the top.
I might have been slowed down a little bit this year, but there is no stopping this train. It's gonna keep on moving. We are gonna hammer it. I'll show them all how to make some gold.
Okay.
All right, sounds good. Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye. We got the boats back.
We won. I have awarded purchase of all the assets.
Shawn gets the word he's rescued his fleet from bankruptcy.
You win one battle and you gotta fight another one.
But raising $400,000 was just the beginning. There's still a long way to go before the dredges are fully paid off.
It's just like buying a car. I have to put down a big down payment and keep making payments if I want to keep it. In the end, I have to come up with $1.3 million.
To pay off his debts and turn a profit this season, Shawn needs a whopping 2,000 ounces.
Now we got access to the boats, we can hit it full throttle. And these guys are out there digging away. They can keep digging away, but
we're gonna get out there and kick their ass. That's what we're gonna do. They don't have a chance.
First order of business for the former Mr. Gold. Get his prize fighter back to work.
Here she is. No more screwing around. It's time to get this boat in the water. Yeah!
It's a great feeling to get everything back.
Trying to get her picked up right now.
Getting the Christine Rose off dry land and back into the Bering Sea will take more than just manpower. For this job, Shawn's inflating giant airbags under the hull to act as a rolling conveyor belt.
Everything's good. We're off the blocks, on the bags. Time to move it.
A 4,000 horsepower loader and the long arm of Shawn's excavator will push and pull the Christine Rose down the ramp and hopefully into the water with ease.
If there is a gold god, I'm hoping they let me put this boat in the water without anything going seriously wrong.
We're gonna start moving right now. Easy!
How we looking there, Cody?
I think I can handle it.
Must be a good sign. We got a bald eagle sitting watching over us, protecting us. There it is.
Getting her back and getting her where she belongs is an amazing feeling. It's a big weight off my shoulders for sure. Christine Rose belongs on the Bering Sea.
We're in the water. Let's go make some gold.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Feels like another chance for me. Even though things have been really bad lately, I can see the light at the end of the tunnel. Things are gonna get better, starting with me taking back that crown of Mr. Gold.
It was cloudy, it was miserable, we couldn't see underneath the ocean, blah, 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 100 excuses.
Hopefully we made a bunch of gold today, but who knows?
Well, I don't know.
After battling low visibility, Captain Chris Kelly is hoping his repaired sluice box actually captured some gold.
I just hope to God there's some gold in there somewhere.
Bad visibility. At this point, we're just playing a guessing game. I have no idea really what we're getting. The only way to really know what you have is to do a clean out. We did way better than I thought we did, thank God.
With funds desperately needed to realize Chris's vision of a new ship.
Here's the gold, Bill.
Already.
The Kellys are wasting no time turning their gold into cold, hard cash.
Look at that, isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, six.
Seven.
Gold is a beautiful thing, isn't it?
Eight. Come on, baby.
9.40, guys. What do you think of that?
9.4 ounces is worth over $14,000.
Your big boat idea is going to come through, I think.
It's going to happen for sure, one way or another.
I'm really happy with 9.4 ounces. Fort Davis is worth it.
Okay. Thanks, Bill.
Thank you, Bill. I really appreciate it. I know this is going to work out for me. We're going to get 100 ounces no matter what.
Hey, we had a good cleanout.
We had a great cleanout. It's going to get better every single time now.
Now back on the water.
Let's go! Yeah!
Captain Shawn Pomrenke isn't on the gold just yet.
It's coming for you, Ken.
But he is on the warpath.
We're to the race a little late, but better late than never.
And he still has a fighting chance to win back the crown of Mr. Gold.
That's looking way better.
That flag symbolizes a new start for the Christine Rose and crew. Gave everybody a little head start. They needed it. It's game on. The real Mr. Gold's finally arrived. There's no stopping the real Mr. Gold.